Hi and welcome to my channel. In this video, we'll explore Excel's spill range feature. I'll cover the basics and real-world uses of dynamic array formulas. Let's dive in. A spill range is a dynamic set of values returned by a formula that can automatically expand or contract to fit adjacent cells. For example, in the video, I entered a formula into cell E3 that returns a range of values spanning 2 columns and 5 rows, which spills over from E3 to F7. This illustrates a basic use of a dynamic array formula, where the values automatically fill the necessary cells to display the entire range of results. You cannot modify or delete values within a spilled range. To make changes, you must adjust the original formula that generates the spill. Now, spill ranges don't always behave perfectly. If there's an obstacle in the cells where the range wants to spill, Excel will show a spill error. Here's an example. If we put some text in a cell that the formula needs, like this, the formula will throw the spill error. To fix this, you need to clear the obstructing cells. Once the range has space, it will spill as intended. Some Excel functions, like unique, sort, filter, and sequence, work perfectly with spill ranges. The sequence function generates a list of sequential numbers in an array. For example, this formula creates a 5x3 grid of numbers, and notice how the result automatically spills into the surrounding cells. You only enter the formula once, but Excel takes care of filling all the required cells. As mentioned earlier, Excel displays a spill error if there are obstacles in the cells where the range needs to spill. Once those cells are clear, the range will spill correctly. Next, let's discuss the sort function, which arranges the contents of a range or array. This function returns a dynamic array that spills into adjacent cells. For example, the formula shown on the screen sorts the range A2 to B15 by the values in the second column in descending order and automatically spills the result into the surrounding cells. Excel highlights the spill range with a dashed border around the affected cells. Click on the formula cell to see this outline. You can reference an entire spill range using the hashtag operator. For example, if your spill range starts in E3, you can use E3 hashtag to reference the entire range. Type the formula equals E3 hashtag in a new cell, and Excel will automatically include all cells in the spill range, regardless of its size. The hashtag operator is useful for functions like sum, count, and others. For example, sum E3 hashtag calculates the sum of all values in the spill range starting at E3, equivalent to sum range E3 to F16, where the range E3 to F16 represents the spill range. Similarly, count E3 hashtag counts the number of numeric values in the spill range. If the spill range changes in size, the formulas using hashtag will automatically update to reflect this. With a static range like sum E3 to F16, you'd have to manually adjust the formula if the range changes, which can be cumbersome and prone to errors. Note, the sum function only adds numeric values and treats text values as zero, so you don't need to worry about non-numeric data affecting your results. Spill ranges can be formatted dynamically, just like any other range. Let's apply some conditional formatting to highlight values in the spill range. Select the cells in the spill range you want to format, then go to the Home tab, click on Conditional Formatting, and choose a rule. For example, if you highlight duplicate values, the formatting will update dynamically with any changes to the spill range. In this section, we'll explore how the index function can work with spill ranges. This function can extract specific elements from an array. When combined with spill ranges, it becomes even more dynamic. Let's break down a series of examples to understand its full potential. This formula is asking for the value in the first row and the first column of the spill range. The hashtag at the end of E3 means that the formula is referencing a spill range, which includes all the cells automatically filled by the formula in cell E3. Now, change the third parameter to 2. This formula will then retrieve the value from the first row and second column of the spill range starting at E3. To retrieve values from both the first and second columns, change the third parameter to an array by specifying the column numbers within curly brackets. The formula will then return the elements from the first and second columns of the first row. Let's now extend it to multiple rows from the spill range. To retrieve data from 2 rows, change the second parameter to an array with row numbers separated by semicolons within curly brackets. This formula will return elements from the specified rows and columns. To display data from 5 rows, Adjust the second parameter similarly, entering the row numbers separated by semicolons, as shown on the screen. The third parameter of the index function specifies the column from which to retrieve data. If you want to display results from a single column, you can simply enter the column number directly instead of using an array. For example, with the formula shown on the screen, it retrieves data from the first column for the first 5 rows. If you change the third parameter to 2, it will return the values from the second column. Next, use the sequence function in the second parameter to dynamically generate row numbers instead of manually specifying them. This approach is especially useful for retrieving large sets of data from a spill range, as it makes the process more flexible. If you need to adjust the number of rows later, you can simply modify the sequence input rather than manually updating the array. For example, sequence having value 5 generates numbers 1 through 5 dynamically. This allows you to retrieve the first 5 rows from both columns, just as before, but with a more adaptable and automated approach. The cell reference E3 hashtag in the first parameter of the index function represents the result of the sort function, which sorted the range A2 to be 15 based on the second column B. Instead of referencing the result in E3, you can directly use the sort function within the index function as the first parameter, as shown on the screen. The index function can handle various array functions, functions that return an array or spill range, such as unique, sort, and filter. For example, this formula first sorts the range A2, B15 by the second column in descending order using the sort function, and then the index function retrieves the first 5 rows from both columns. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and feel free to leave any questions or suggestions for future tutorials in the comments below. See you in the next one.